Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel adds his voice to the growing chorus to ban politicians during aid distribution activities. Pimentel says politicians who are invited as guests by state agencies should not take part in the actual distribution, especially if it involves cash. The senator believes it should also be made clear to the people which agencies the funds are sourced. Pimentel's comments echo the observation of fellow Senator J.V. Ejercito, who said politicians should be barred from taking part in government-initiated aid distribution. Several groups of media men urged the Marcos Jr. administration to work on capturing a fugitive ex-governor who is linked to the murder of Philippine journalist and environmentalist Jerry Ortega. The appeal was made by representatives from the Committee to Protect Journalists, Free Press Unlimited, Reporters Without Borders, and the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines. They noted the standing arrest warrant issued by the Supreme Court for former Palawan Governor Joel Reyes. The journalists said they have relayed information on the former governor's whereabouts to Assistant Justice Secretary Mico Clavano. The High Court ordered the rearrest of Reyes last year over the 2011 killing of Ortega in Puerto Princesa City. Ortega had accused Reyes of misusing profits from the Malampaya gas and oil fields.
We are here today, urge and call upon President Marcos Jr. administration and the law enforcement agency to act upon this crucial piece of information and to immediately bring, and arrest the mastermind behind Jerry Ortega's murder. So it's time for us to say enough is enough.
Five Philippine policemen who were fired over the wrongful death of a teenager have been released from detention. The Jail Management Bureau says they were freed after a Navotas court ruled on their case. The dismissed Navotas City policemen were accused of murdering 17-year-old Jemboy Baltazar. The teenager was shot and killed in August last year when police mistook him for a criminal they were pursuing. A Navotas court convicted five of them on lesser charges, one for homicide and the four others for illegal discharge of firearms. One was acquitted due to reasonable doubt. The five policemen and three others linked to the case are also appealing their dismissal. As for PNP spokesperson Colonel Gene Fajardo, the acquitted policeman will not be automatically reinstated since he is still facing administrative charges.
Actually, sir, even before the issue once po ng decision po ng RTC ay nakapag-apila na po sila noong November last year. But since nagkaroon na po, lumabas na po itong decision ng korte, like I said, hindi po automatic na makireinstate po itong na-acquit. So regardless, no, na-acquit po siya dito sa kaso po na ito ay hindi po automatic na ma-approve po yung appeal niya in his favor much more kung makireinstate po sila kasi may proseso.
Philippine authorities are investigating the illegal recruitment scheme involving South Korea's seasonal workers program for overseas Filipino workers. ABS-CBN correspondent Katrina Domingo joins us on the line for details. Kat, the details please.
Hi, Erika. The Department of Migrant Workers has identified 66 individuals who may be involved in the illegal recruitment of Filipinos seeking temporary employment in South Korea through the country's seasonal workers program. Hans Katnak, officer in charge of the DMW, says there are some individuals who have been taking advantage of the SWP, where Filipinos are hired in South Korea for at least 2 months to augment the number of farm workers during the East Asian country's peak harvest season. Katnak says there have been Korean agents as well as their Filipino counterparts who have been illegally charging between 20,000 pesos and 40,000 pesos just to put these potential workers, or just to find a place of employment for these potential workers under South Korea's SWP. Takdak says this is illegal as this is not sanctioned by the government. And unfortunately, some Filipinos fell victim to these illegal brokers as they can earn around 80,000 pesos a month as a temporary farmhand in South Korea. Katnak says the Department of Justice is expected to file illegal recruitment and estafa cases against individuals who are part of the modus. Now, the DMW is now looking to forge an agreement between the national governments of the Philippines and South Korea to further regulate the SWP. Katnak says under the current setup, employment deals are only signed between local governments here in the Philippines and another partner local government there in South Korea. He says that he reminds the public that in January 2024, the Philippine government imposed a moratorium on South Korea's temporary hiring scheme for Filipino workers after receiving some 160 labor complaints. These issues among Filipino seasonal workers in South Korea involve violations of contracts, uncomfortable and undesirable living conditions, underpayment of wages, as well as the withholding of passports. Tatnak says the Philippine government, particularly the DMW, is not here to end the program, but only to regulate it to ensure that there are sufficient safeguards in place. Rica.
Hi, Kat. Just one question. Was there any mention of those who have already been, who has already flown to South Korea to start their jobs? Will they be brought back to the country?
Not in particular, Rica. Those who are already working in South Korea will have to finish their contract first before going back to the Philippines. They will not be deported to the Philippines. In fact, the DMW even processed permits and visas of several workers here who have already received employment opportunities, who have already received guaranteed employment opportunities in South Korea when the moratorium was imposed. The DMW has allowed the deployment of 39 Filipinos from Pampanga to South Korea this week, and they will be allowing another 70 Filipinos to fly to the East Asian countries by next week.
So there isn't any Filipinos who were able to fly to South Korea that were part of the illegal recruitment scheme?
Rica, those who are already in South Korea are the ones complaining about the illegal recruitment scheme. Mm-hmm. They are complaining that they had to pay certain amounts that were not part of Philippine or South Korean regulation.
Mm-hmm. Rica. Thank you so much, Katrina Domingo, reporting live. China defends its military presence in the West Philippine Sea as it slams the Philippines' joint patrols in the disputed territory. But Manila reminds Beijing it has no business interfering in Philippine-held waters. We have this report.
China vows to continue using its military to counter what it calls provocations and infringements in the South China Sea. Chinese media reported the allegations made by China's Ministry of National Defense that Philippine Coast Guard ships have repeatedly illegally entered waters near the Scarborough Shoal, which Beijing calls Wangyan Island. Last week, a Chinese maritime militia vessel tried to block a vessel of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources delivering fuel and relief supplies to Filipino fishermen near Scarborough Shoal. But the Chinese official asserts the on-site handling of the Philippine vessel was reasonable, lawful, and restrained. The official also called on the Philippines not to act unilaterally and cause trouble by holding joint military exercises and joint patrols with the U.S. and other countries. But Philippine Foreign Affairs Department Undersecretary Teresita Lazaro says it is within any sovereign nation's rights to form partnerships with like-minded countries to address maritime security issues, among others.
This is the Philippines. It's a sovereign country. We always are aware of our sovereignty, sovereign rights and jurisdiction, so nobody can tell us what to do. We have to go and seek or like-minded countries on this aspect of maritime.
On Friday, Lazaro attended a forum on trilateral cooperation between the Philippines, India, and Japan to ensure maritime security in the Indo-Pacific region. Indian Ambassador Shambhu Kumaran was also present and stressed the need for greater cooperation among the three countries.
Of course, the geopolitical logic of this partnership is very visible, given the recent developments in the region, especially in the maritime domain. Naturally, both India and Japan have prioritized our partnership with the Philippines in the area of maritime security. And I would think that the maritime domain will be a possible area for our three countries to work together more actively.
The DFA affirmed that the Philippines is already engaged in multiple aspects of cooperation with Japan and India.
We're developing a stronger linkage also with India. That started when Secretary Manalo, I think, went to India last year. Mm-hmm. And that was the first time our Indian friends have mentioned the arbitral tribunal decision.
But Lazaro clarified a trilateral cooperation needs to be formalized between governments, and nothing has been initiated so far between the Philippines, India, and Japan.
Philippine Airport Authority is expressing frustration following reports of a bedbug infestation affecting chairs at NAIA Terminals 2 and 3. Another video of a rodent running around the airport's departure area has also gone viral. The Manila International Airport Authority says it is evaluating their contracts with their service providers.
Pinapareview nga sa akin ni General Manager Eric ang lahat ng kontrata, ang kanilang mga obligasyon, scope of work, ang kanilang key performance indicators. At ganun din po ang katanungan namin dahil kung obligasyon nila na siguraduhin malinis ang mga infrastruktura, ang mga kagamitan sa loob ng ating paliparan, eh wala pong dapat dahilan para makalusot ang mga surot na ito.
Ayun na.
With that, sir, on Monday po, sir, pinatawag po sila lahat ni GM Eric. Kakausapin po natin ang lahat ng pest control pati ng housekeeping ng bawat terminal ng ating airport. At kami po ay sisilipin din po namin ang kanilang performance evaluation, ang kanilang track record. Dahil sabi ni GM Eric po, kung mapapatunayan na may kapabayaan po dito, eh titignan po natin kung magkakansela po tayo ng mga kontrata.